Okay, guys, we have started about biochemical oxygen demand. Its definition is amount of oxygen consumed by bacteria during the decomposition of organic matter in presence of oxygen, okay, at a certain temperature. So usually for 5 days it is 20 degrees Celsius and for 3 days it is 25 degrees Celsius. Okay. So this part we have discussed. There are the different methods to calculate the BOD or to determine the BOD. One first method is the direct method, and simply you can determine dissolved oxygen consumed for on first day and on fifth day. That is the direct method. And in dilution method, you can multiply to that dissolved oxygen consumed by dilution ratio. And how to calculate dilution ratio? That volume of diluted sample upon volume of undiluted sewage sample. Okay. So organic matter present in the wastewater belongs to two groups, major two groups, that is carbonaceous matter and nitrogenous matter. Okay, so here in a carbonaceous and nitrogenous BOD, the oxygen demand could also arise from nitrification requirements where nitrogen waste such as ammonia is converted to nitrates by autotrophic bacteria using oxygen as an energy source. They are using oxygen as an energy source. Okay. The requirement of dissolved oxygen for the process is called a nitrogenous BOD or NBOD, while requirement of oxygen for degrading carbonaceous organic matter is referred as carbonaceous biochemical oxygen demand or CBOD. Generally, the nitrifiers have lower growth rates and do not flourish until the food supply for the heterotrophic microorganisms, that is CBOD consumption, and therefore NBOD does not become discriminable until approximately 7 days of incubation have occurred. So usually whatever BOD we are performing within the 5 days, that is a CBOD, because NBOD takes a lot of time for the consumption. So usually whatever BOD on regular basis we are determining, that is CBOD, and that quantity is also bigger quantity. Okay, so that here also you can look at this figure. Okay, BOD calculated, it can be against the days. Okay, it is a time dependent parameter, as oxygen consumed by bacteria would increase the progress of time. Quantifies oxygen consumed in a sample within a 5 day period, that is known as the BOD 5. Then what is ultimate BOD or UBOD or BOD U? Okay. So all these notifications you please remember while solving examples or in the paper also, it will be given in the notification form. It may not be written in the full form. So ultimate BOD, what is this ultimate BOD? Quantifies the oxygen required for the total biochemical degradation of organic matter. In the last figure, you can see here. So this is a carbonaceous BOD, and this is a nitrogenous BOD, and this one is the UBOD. UBOD in the sense summation of NBOD and CBOD, nitrogenous BOD and carbonaceous BOD. Its summation is the UBOD, or you can say it is a ultimate BOD. Okay, so generally the 5 day period is not long enough for complete oxidation, but it provides sufficient time for microbial acclimation and for substantial oxidation. So the BOD test is a standardized test where final DO is subtracted from the initial DO to know the oxygen consumed during the period of incubation. So that is what we have discussed till the yesterday's lecture. Okay, now the formulation of first stage BOD we will see with the help of mathematical equations. So I will stop sharing this and I will open the whiteboard. Give me 1 second. Let me get connected. Okay guys, so mathematical formula we will look after for the first stage BOD formulation. So BOD formulation in the sense the rate of decomposition, we are finding the rate of decomposition, okay, at a given temperature. So rate of decomposition usually is directly proportional to the organic compound, amount of organic matter present in a sewage. What I am saying, a rate of decomposition, something went wrong, let me, I'm not able to catch with this. So what I'm saying, rate of decomposition is directly proportional to the amount of organic matter present in sewage. Okay, so present in sewage. So this way, so we are finding the first stage BOD, or we are studying the first stage BOD formulation. In the first stage BOD formulation, at a given temperature, or we can say the rate at which BOD is getting satisfied means the rate of decomposition is directly proportional to the amount of organic matter present in sewage. So here BOD is getting satisfied. Okay, so same statement we can write in a mathematical form. Like this way, I will try. I'm getting difficulty to use this tool for some time, but immediately after some time, I will be getting habitual with this. So what I'm saying, rate of decomposition is directly proportional to the amount of organic matter present in sewage, that we can write in a mathematical form, that DLT upon DT is equal to minus K dash into LT. Okay. Minus K dash into LT. So what is this LT? LT is nothing but the amount of first stage BOD, or amount of first stage BOD remained, amount of organic matter remained at any time t. That is nothing but the LT, amount of organic matter remained at any time t. Or we can say amount of first stage BOD remained at any time t, and usually LT, it is measured in a milligram per liter. Okay, it is measured usually in the milligram per liter. Then what is this K dash? What is this K dash? So that K dash is nothing but the deoxygenation rate constant. It is nothing but the K dash is nothing but the deoxygenation rate constant. Rate constant to the base E, or if you are using it to the base 10, it can be used a simple K, deoxygenation rate constant to the base E. Okay, so before I'm going to explain this, I will explain with one stream. So this is a stream. Yesterday I have started to explain this part. So here, this is a spot where you are adding sewage. Okay, due to addition of sewage, there is a organic matter present into this sewage, and the microorganisms are also present into this sewage. So when you are adding here, at this time, it will start decomposition process. So decomposition, rate of decomposition will be greater at this stage than this stage. Here also water is available, sewage is available, organic matter is available, microorganisms are also available, but the decomposition rate at this stage will be greater than this stage, because here no sufficient oxygen is available. No sufficient oxygen is available. Once you are dropping that into the river or any another new fresh water body, there is a sufficient dissolved oxygen. And that dissolved oxygen, microorganisms are using as an energy source. And with that energy, they will decompose the organic material and they will get their own food here during the decomposition process. So that's why whenever here you are dipping that dissolved oxygen, whenever you are dropping the sewage into the fresh water body, the rate of deoxygenation starts increasing. But naturally, when I say here, this is a chart I will go for. So this will be chart, you can see here. So here I want to show, this is the distance, means this can be a distance. So at this point, I have added a sewage in particular river, and sewage is moving along with the water flow up to this distance. But when you have added sewage, immediately you will be observing very less dissolved oxygen. Here you can assume here is the DO, okay, DO level. So less dissolved oxygen may be there, and before addition, here you are not adding. I will try to recorrect that figure. Or
हेलो मैम, अनम्यूटा है। हेलो मैडम, हेलो। हाँ, इतनी
Oh my God, I'm extremely sorry. I was just explaining, but my audio system was off. You are not audible, ma'am. You are not audible. Many of you have replied, but I have not seen. I was keep on explaining. Extremely sorry. One second, I will explain. Someone should loudly say that your voice is not audible. Okay, my laptop voice was also low. That's why maybe. Sorry. Okay. So I was giving an example of river. Here I have shown. Here you are adding the sewage. Okay. And once you are adding sewage into this portion, it will start reducing the dissolved oxygen level. This is the spot in a model form I am showing here. This is the natural form, that is the river. And here you are adding the sewage. Okay. So here in the model form I am showing, here is the up to this level, means before you are adding sewage in a particular river, the level of dissolved oxygen will be in a saturated form. Saturated dissolved oxygen level you will observe here in the particular river. So once you are adding sewage into this particular river, it starts decreasing the level of dissolved oxygen suddenly. Why? Because in the sewage, there is a organic matter present and microorganisms are also present. These microorganisms decomposing the organic matter. Why they are decomposing? Because organic matter is the food of microorganism and hence they are decomposing the organic matter. But for the decomposition process, they need energy. And in what form they are using their energy? In the form of dissolved oxygen. So here when it is getting entered, before getting entered into this, there will be decomposition rate may not be there or it will be very less because here is no sufficient dissolved oxygen available. But once it is dropped here, because this river is saturated with dissolved oxygen, immediately decomposition starts. So when decomposition starts, the dissolved oxygen level drops down, starts filling the scarcity of dissolved oxygen in that particular river. And after some certain time, it starts automatically increasing. Why it is increasing? Because of the solar radiations, wind movements, studying of water, these activities. So many of the time the record, the network is getting disconnected. So that's why we are facing this problem. So here, you can see, so when you are observing such kinds of dropping and then raising the oxygen, so this kind of activities are being observed in respect of dissolved oxygen and time. So if organic matter initially added over here, that is known as that notation we will give L naught. Okay, L naught is the initial organic matter present into that sewage. Okay, so at certain time, any time t, if you are finding the organic matter present into that sewage, that will be Lt. Okay, and in that respect, dissolved oxygen level D naught, DO naught, you can say DOT, you can say. Okay, so likewise, at a certain time you have taken. Suppose here you have taken up at 5 days. Okay, so in that case, I can note down here LT as a L5U, or you can find out this is the L equation, L notation we are giving for the organic matter. Y notation we will give for the amount of BOD present into that sewage, and DO notation amount of dissolved oxygen present into that particular sewage or the stream. So that way we will start finding out the first stage BOD formulation in a stream. So while finding out the first stage BOD formulation, I can say you, so there is a rate of decomposition in this semester. I'm first time using this tool, so I may be facing a problem, but tomorrow I may get practiced with this. So first stage BOD formulation is the rate of decomposition is directly proportional to the amount of organic matter present into that sewage. Okay, so that way DLT, that, so same we are representing in the form of mathematical equation, DLT upon DT is equal to minus K dash into LT. So what is this LT? LT is the amount of organic matter present at any time T in a milligram per liter, And what is this K? K is nothing but the deoxygenation rate constant. It is a deoxygenation rate constant. Deoxygenation rate constant. Okay. Or if it is given K dash or K, deoxygenation rate constant to the base 10, and K dash is the deoxygenation rate constant to the base E. Okay, or the same equation DLT by DT, when you integrate with respect to time T is equal to, zero to time T is equal to T, we will get, who will tell me? We will get LT is equal to L naught, is it? Because we are integrating that equation by in the time between time t is equal to 0 to time t is equal to t. So in that case, we will get Lt is equal to L naught. And I can rewrite that equation in this form here. Dlt upon Lt is equal to minus k dash. So sorry, integration here, DLT upon LT is equal to minus K dash into integration of DT. Okay. Or otherwise, in the form of log to the base equation, I can write this equation as a log to the base E, LT upon L naught is equal to minus K dash into T. Okay. Or you may also write this equation in another form, that is LT upon L naught is equal to, LT upon L naught is equal to e raised to minus k dash into t. Or if I want to write it into the form of 10 to the base 10, I will write is LT upon L naught is equal to 10 raised to minus k into t. Okay, minus k into t. So what is that k? K is nothing but the rate constant. Okay. Deoxygenation rate constant. So in the earlier figure, I forgot to tell you. So whichever figure I have drawn here, like the oxygen starts reduction and then it starts increasing. Okay. So that kind of outcome we are observing. And behind that, there are two oxygen, two actions. First action is the decomposition of organic matter starts, and here the reduction of oxygen starts observing like this. At the same time, the natural phenomena will increase the level of dissolved oxygen and it will increase the dissolved oxygen level. And so outcome of these two actions, we will be observing as a dissolved oxygen sac curve. Usually it is called as the dissolved oxygen sac curve. So amount of oxygen reduction, that is called a rate of deoxygenation. This is the curve for the rate of